And welcome back to another episode of Steve Drives a Truck. I guess that's what's happening here. All right, so this is episode 3. In episode 2, we drove from Amsterdam to Dover, delivering some sandwich panels, which will keep all the inhabitants of the UK sandwiches nice and flat and perfect. I didn't actually look up what a sandwich panel is. Let's find a job. Still doing quick jobs. Let's see. So weird. That says Canterbury, yet everything here says Dover. Not seeing anything great out of Dover. You know, I'm not really seeing much of anything that's great, but we gotta take something. Oh, here's one that makes use of our new heavy cargo. That's running from, kind of already seen that route, so I don't want to run that. It doesn't really pay that much anyway, though it probably gives a little bit better experience than Right, look at that, an articulated trailer. That one might be fun. I mean, it looks like it pays the best. 27 euros a kilometer. Excuse me. Just ate some peanuts and I have peanuts stuck in my throat. Let's see. So the most we're looking at is 10 grand. And that is a very long drive, though it's entirely new, so that might not be a bad one, delivering 21 tons of sugar. Though at 14 euros a kilometer, it's really one of the worst paying in terms of, value for distance. I mean, this one's pretty new as well. It's taking us into, I guess that would be considered central Germany. We've been in North Germany before. So that definitely... And plus the articulated trailer should be an interesting haul. We're looking at a 6-hour, 3-minute trip time, 380 kilometers. Yeah, I think we can go with that one. The important thing this early in the game is to make sure you're getting the best possible value for your money, I think.
Ready to roll.
So... Oh. Yeah, it's weird. My accelerator sticks sometimes. Ooh, we're in a DAF truck. Let's take a look at the interior real fast. I can't see it real well at night, but... Looks pretty nice. I'll have to take a slightly better look in daylight. So, let's just zoom in here a little bit. All our trips have originated from Amsterdam, so that's well explored. Arnhem here, it doesn't have any discoverables, so I don't know if it's worth stopping off there. So we cover a little bit of route we've seen before, and then right here we get into some new stuff. Now it looks like there's Dortmund and Oberhausen like right next to each other. So we have two discoverables here and none here in Oberhausen. So let's see if we do that and that. We add, we're adding only about 25 minutes, about 25 minutes, I think, what was it, like 6 hours and like 3 minutes or something, so we're adding just over 20 minutes to our ride, and we'll discover Oberhausen on the way, and we'll get two discoverables in Dortmund. I don't see it being worth going here through Duisburg, probably. No, because we have to kind of loop around. So I don't see that. Go away. Go away. No, I don't want you there. Why will that not go away? Okay. Let's maybe if we zoom out a little bit. There we go. All right, so we'll head on down this way. Okay, that's really all there is on the way there. You know what? Let's just come in a different way and grab that discoverable and castle real quick. Castle? Pretty sure it's not pronounced like the English word castle. Okay, so that looks like our finalized route. We're looking at 6.5 hours, 404 kilometers. What that's adding, what, about 24 kilometers to the journey and just under a half hour? I feel like that should be doable. Okay, and at this point, we've explored 0.5% of the map. Great job. All right, let's go. Let's have some fun.
Drive safe.
Let's get our what are we hauling again? We are hauling radiators. Well, that's less interesting than sandwich panels, but I suppose we're starting off at 4:30 in the morning. Let's get the. Ooh, I do like that. I do like how that lights up. I do like the colors on the dash. I think I might have a DAF mod installed. That changes it. Let's start in like third and see if it can pull it, 'cause yeah, that feels pretty good. Whoops, I'm not even gonna check.
Turn right.
'Cause it's okay. Oh, that's right, articulated trailer. Crap. That's right. I'm driving a double. Okay, let's back up a bit. Did that do any damage? No. Got away with no damage. Oh, that's right. I'm pulling an articulated trailer. And I have it, and it's stuck already. Freaking wonderful. I'm stuck against the gate already. Okay, let's take a look at this. Okay. Okay. What a great way to start the what a great way to start off the day, huh? What a great way to start off the video. Get stuck on my way out of the yard. Okay, I think that did it. Whew! There we
Get
go.
ready to turn left. Turn left.
Okay. All right, let's hope we do better from here on out. Let's see if I can, not get stuck on a fence instantly. Okay, so I'm gonna need to pull way straight out here, I would say. Well, actually, there's not really anything to get caught on, so. Okay. Thank you, green light. Just turn nice and wide. Ooh, not that wide. I don't think I got. Oh, I'm getting so lucky. None of this is doing any damage at all. Though I do like this truck quite a bit. Oh, what? Oh man, are you serious? Are you serious? How are my lights not on? I specifically turned them on. Anyway, let's continue on. Oh, it's 80. Yeah, let's actually go something resembling the speed limit. Well, actually, we have to
Keep left,
exit.
and then continue straight on.
Keep left. Okay.
Go straight on.
Definitely gonna wanna slow down a little bit up here. Uh-oh. Come on. Why am I not moving? I'm going backwards. Come on. There we go. Hey, wait, this is the... Come on, that wasn't my fault. He tried to pass me when there wasn't room. Okay, so... Already that's $1,000 probably of my... It's probably $1,000 of my profits gone in offenses. So I need to be very careful from here on out. This can't keep happening. It's going to wreck me. The headlights were my fault. The traffic offense was not my fault. I thought this game had a blame system in it. I thought it actually tried to take into account who was at fault for accidents. I thought it did. I've definitely been hit by cars before and not charged for it. So yeah, I thought there was some sort of a blame system. Okay, this particular truck does not appear to have a cruise control display. So that's a little annoying. We have 389 kilometers of fuel and 379 kilometers to go. Oh boy, are we cutting it close. It's nice to see the sun come up, though. It is nice to leave early like this and watch the sun come up. Ooh. Yeah, that's about as long as I can look at that and not hit something. I don't know why it's so hard for me to steer if I'm not looking perfectly straight ahead. It's really strange. You'd think if I just held the wheel in the same position, I'd be fine, but I'm not. I start swerving all over the road. It's really strange. That's really strange. Anyway, I've changed my recording setup a bit. Prior to this, for the first two episodes, I was using the I think it was called the Microsoft Game DVR, and it was putting some weird static in the game audio. I'm hoping that'll be fixed by changing to OBS, which is what I'm using for this. And I mean, even more than the static, you know what? I just realized I'm driving in the middle of a lane. Sorry, guys. Gosh, it's really difficult to see the road lines. I think I have a road texture mod installed. I wonder if that's doing something weird. Because it is really, really hard to see the lines on the road. Well, now it's not so hard. Oh yeah, now you're getting a real good view of that sunset. We better turn that cruise control up a little more. I'm not quite going fast enough. So yeah, like I was saying, I changed my recording setup
and then exit right.
Because was I getting static, I'm playing in 4K at 60 frames a second, and the recording program I was using was recording at 30 frames a second, 1080p. I know 4K probably isn't a real big thing gaming-wise, but when I can get it, you know, if I can get it running in 1080p, I mean 4K, I would like to instead of 1080p.
Keep right, and then exit right.
Whoops.
Recompute.
What, you told me to exit? Oh my gosh, that's a hard turn. I thought it said exit right. Whoops, wrong side of the road. No, okay, I thought that truck was coming at me, but I guess not. Yeah, it looks good. So yeah, I'm hopefully... Because I was wondering why my editing program kept... Because normally it exports at the same as what it got. So like if you feed it a 4K 60 frames a second file, when you go to export, by default, it should be 4K 60 frames a second. Come on. And I wondered why I kept outputting, you know, 1080 30 frames, and I had to keep manually adjusting it to, you know, I had to keep manually adjusting it. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. So, finally, I just looked at the source file and found it was 1080p, 30 frames a second. So, hopefully, if I did everything correctly, when you see this, it should be 4K, 60 frames a second. Should look a little bit nicer than the other ones did in terms of frame rate. Ooh, getting up this hill is a little difficult. But I think this truck has it. This is a pretty nice truck. I will give it that. One thing I do want to do just real quickly here, and I haven't been getting good pictures for good thumbnails for my videos. So what I want to do just real quick is take a picture real quick here. No, that's not what I mean to do. Not sure how I should be doing this. Maybe about like that? No, I feel like it should be maybe down a little more. Yeah, maybe like that. Yeah, I think something like that might work. Down just a little more. Yeah, I think that kind of works. And take one that's a little more up, just in case. Okay, I should be able to do something with those. Alright, sorry about that, guys. Oh, crap! I bet it would have been nicer in the if I'd done that during sunrise, but, you know. Sun's pretty high up in the sky now. Nice sound barriers on the side there. It's really pretty out this way. Nice smokestacks in the distance there. Oh, hang on, wait a minute. Right, that should be about 80. I think it's about time we can turn our headlights off. Or actually, you know what? Maybe leave them on. Alright. We have entered Germany. Now, Germany's a good country to start in. My main save starts in Berlin, and I've had North Rhine-Westphalia. But Germany's a good place to start. That's where my main save takes place, which I haven't actually played since I started this. Just because I don't feel like constantly upgrading and downgrading Euro Truck to switch between versions. So yeah, this Steve Drives a Truck save is the only one I've used recently. Better give these guys some room to merge, especially with me and my double trailers here. I haven't driven double trailers in a while. Like, I don't know, those never come up as options. I never really see articulated trailers, like, in my main save as, you know, just for the contract jobs I do. It's never articulated, it's only ever, single trailers. Okay, 220 kilometers to go. We're looking at about 3 hours 45 minutes, and I'm looking at about 310 in fuel. Oh, wait a minute, I'm driving way, way, way too high. Let's get into 12th gear, and interestingly enough, I would think the fuel remaining... Oh, wait a minute, I'm looking at liters. I'm sorry, I'm not used to this display. We have 304 liters of fuel left. I have 618.
Get ready to turn left.
What's going on here? Detour? Or is it the edge of the map?
Turn left.
Oh, shoot, is there a light here? No. Okay, keep it real wide. You have a double trailer, don't forget. Okay, so we're now okay. Okay, starting in third or fourth seems about right for this. I mean, a double trailer for me is seriously enough of a jump. Second exit. Oh, shit, stop. No, why am I going backwards? How am I going backwards? Okay. Alright, let's just wait for these guys to clear out. I don't think I need these lights anymore. Just let's chill out here, wait until we have some room. Okay, now this is gonna be a little dicey. Let's just keep her slow. Okay.
Exit now.
And I don't see anyone behind me, so I think I can just go. Yeah, this DAF is really nice. I don't think I've ever owned a DAF in any playthrough. But this is definitely a nice little truck, and I'm enjoying this haul quite a bit. One of the issues I have, which I think is a pretty common problem with Thrustmaster. Oops. Can we stop in time? Yes, we can. One of the problems I think that's pretty common with Thrustmaster is my pedals slide back as I play. It's not too big of a problem in Euro Truck because I tend to spend a lot of my time in cruise control and my feet aren't even touching the pedals. But it can get annoying. I feel like they're a little further back than they need to be now. When I was playing iRacing shortly after I got the wheel, which was last week, I guess, I noticed that my legs were stretched out pretty far and the pedals had slipped the whole way back to the wall. I have definitely seen people put cardboard boxes between the wall and the pedals to keep them in place. Kinda wish the Thrustmaster pedals had that had that little carpet grip that the Logitech G29 has. Ooh, we've arrived at Dortmund. Oh, are you serious? You snarly light. You're a snarly rat. Alright. Let's wait. Hey, buddy! Okay, gotta be careful. Don't forget, I have a double trailer, not a single. I'm going to get to the left just a little bit here. Just real slow, real slow. Okay, we're good. Like, this is, I have not, like I said, I have not driven an articulated trailer in a very long time. I know I've seen videos of triple trailers before, and I'm...
And then turn left.
But I cannot remember if that was, another truck dealer. Nice.
Turn left.
But I can't remember if that was a mod or if triple trailers are supported in this game natively. Okay, this one's gonna be tough. I definitely need to go way straight out and turn pretty hard, but I think I got it. I think I got it. Yeah. See, this I have to think a little bit more than when I'm playing a single trailer.
Go straight on.
Okay, yeah, starting in second seems pretty good. Apparently what I want to do from a little bit of research is try and keep my tachometer in the green, because apparently that's where the engine has the most power. Ooh, it's a yield. That's not a yield, Steve. That's a full stop. Okay. And another recruitment agency. Nice. Right, let's just check the map real fast. I forget, am I stopping anywhere else or is that it? No, that's it till we get there. Well, except for the one in Cassel itself, or castle, however you might say that. Okay, so we're looking good. Good, we just gotta wait for the. Oops, it popped up. So, yeah, we have. It's saying 591 kilometers, but like if I downshift here, it should pop up, but it doesn't. Because I'm using less. What was that in the street? There was something in the street on the right there. I couldn't tell quite what it was.
Turn right.
Uh-oh, I think I'm gonna take a sign out. I don't know why I thought completely braking would help. Come on. Yep, one sign. One sign taken out. One sign. Not bad, not bad. The only one thing I don't like about OBS is I don't have a little timer in the corner anymore telling me how long the video is. I used to be able to say, oh, we're at 43 minutes. I have no idea how long we've been at this point. But, yeah, I think OBS should turn out nicer. I think he should have a nicer quality video. Ooh, I'm speeding. I am definitely speeding. Let's just slow that down a little bit.
Keep right, and then turn right.
All right.
Turn right. Keep right, and then turn right.
Oh, going up a hill. We just have to make it to the top. There we go. See, I'm not sure where I should start, and like going up a hill like that, where I should start. In my power band. Should I start at the very bottom of it? Should I be at the middle of it? I'm pretty sure I shouldn't be at the end of the power band. I forgot to turn my email notifications off. I really hope that didn't come up on the recording. I might have to blur it out if it did. That's annoying.
And then turn right.
Keep right and then turn right. Oh, what's going on here? Oh.
Turn right.
Oh no. Ooh, that was not my freaking fault. That idiot ran into me. Not my fault. Swear to God, I'm losing so much of profit on this run because idiots keep running into me and the game keeps charging me for it when it shouldn't be. Boy, I'm getting a lot of email. I think that's the car that hit me. I think. Okay, so 256 kilometers to go, and we're looking at, yeah, we're fine on gas. Should not be an issue at all. There we go, let's hit it at 78. back in the cruise control, even though I'm going 81, and I remember, like, I don't understand, like, why. Maybe this doesn't have a retarder, this engine? I don't know. I thought it came on earlier in the run. Ausfahrt. I mean, I'm sure that's not how it's pronounced, but that's what it looks like.
Keep right, and then turn right.
See, there's the retarder. Like, I don't understand why it's so sporadic.
Keep right, and then turn right.
Okay.
Turn right.
Okay, now this is a little dicey, because I'm always worried about, rolling the truck over, which I've done several times recently. Not on video, but I've definitely done it. Okay, 12th gear usually seems about where I want to be. So I think I should be good. Okay, let's lock her in at 78 and keep going. The truck without a trailer just blows past me. Well, I'm hauling radiators. Never noticed that cab, or did you notice, I should say, that cab really didn't turn very realistically. Almost like it was on ice and it slid. That's strange. One thing I have noticed, and I've been trying unsuccessfully to fix, is it sounds like I'm constantly breathing into my microphone, which is actually not the case at all. I actually have my microphone... Whoa. I actually have my microphone well above my nose. I am definitely not breathing into it at all, but... still sounds like it. That's really strange. It's like I've had jobs at call centers before and it always sounds like I'm breathing directly into the phone. I'm like, I can't, like, make it stop. Maybe it's because I'm just, you know, always have a headset on. Like, one of the things I want to do once I'm working again, which is in 2.5 weeks, by the way, I do have a job. I'm just waiting for it to start. I'm hoping to buy, like, a mic I can clamp onto my desk and bend it over so it's, like, to my left, so it's not anywhere near my face. I think that might fix my problem. I think you can't really hear it so much in this because the engine might be drowning it out.
Keep right, and then
I'm going way too fast. Way too fast. Let's let that car pass.
Turn right.
Ooh, slow down a little bit.
Keep right, and then turn right. Turn right.
Looks like the truck's handling these double trailers pretty well. Sure are exiting a lot. Oh, not again.
Turn right.
Not again. You've got to be kidding me. got to be kidding me. We're supposed to turn right there, and we're not. Looks like we're climbing up a little bit of a hill, because I see I'm losing power. The weird thing is, I mean, with all these detours, I just feel like I am not getting any closer to my goal at all. I feel like, you know, 6 or 7 minutes ago, I was 250 kilometers away, and I'm 250 kilometers away still. Like, I feel like I'm not making any progress at all towards my goal. Oops, going a little too fast. A little bit of engine brake, maybe slow that down a bit. There we go. Now let's check the map real fast. Yeah, look at that. I'm going the wrong way. I am going absolutely the wrong way. I knew something was weird. What's going on here? Because this is where I'm going. This is where I'm pointing. So what is the problem here? It's like routing me in a circle, I think. Like, that's why I keep running across the clothes. It routes me here, and I'm doing this. So I think I'm just running in a circle around Dortmund. Okay, let's do this. If I manually do that, it'll... Do you think that'll work? I mean, we can explore Cologne while I'm at it. But this doesn't make any sense. Like, this is routing me over and over and over and over in a circle. Like, I don't think I'm ever going to get there. That's why I'm constantly exiting, because it keeps trying to take me here. I can't go there. So I go here, and it reroutes me because... Here. Never actually tried to do this before. But if I add in a void right there... No, see, it's... Well, that's not the right place to have the void. Here, There, so if I tell it to avoid that... It's going to loop me around. Because that's closed. So it's going to loop me up to Oberhausen, give me a U-turn, and then send me on my way. This is really interesting. I have never had this problem before with a obstacle, like with a roadblock. It's never kept looping me in a circle like this before, but let's try it this way and see if that works better for me. Yeah, we'll put in a void. Hopefully that avoid should clear things up. I wonder how many times I looped that. I think I saw it 3 times.
Keep right, and then turn right.
Yeah, I think I came across it 3 times.
And then turn right. Turn right.
So I'm assuming it took me going in a circle for 3 rotations before I finally realized there was a problem. Real observant there, Steve. Okay, so we're behind the Esselunga trailer. That's an interesting one. So I turned my air conditioning off in the apartment here just to,
keep right, and then exit
just
right.
So I don't have to deal with so much background noise. And, hoo boy, is it getting warm.
Exit.
It's up to
right.
81 degrees in my apartment. That's Fahrenheit, of course.
Get ready.
Slow down, slow down, slow down. Okay, so gotta be careful here. This looks like it's gonna be tricky. Because of the articulated trailer.
Turn left.
So we want to turn left here. Fur cam! Fur cam! Fur cam sure needs a lot of merchandise. Okay, let's keep her nice and wide. We are definitely running low on gas.
Keep left, and then turn left.
Okay,
turn
so
left.
We're going up a slight hill. Better put my foot down. Woo! Hopefully I don't get a, that just barely made it clear. Hopefully I don't get a traffic offense for that. I did not. Okay, so if I'm in the middle of the power band, it seems to have a relatively decent pull up hills. So maybe I should be going for middle of the band instead of start of it. So like I was saying earlier, I have a job starting in 2.5 weeks, so I'm trying to record as many of these as I can and just schedule them to come out, so even if I can't record these when I'm working, you should still be getting some new content from me. Not that I've gotten any views on episode 1 yet, and episode 2 is scheduled to go out next week, so it's definitely going to be a while before number 2 gets any views. So it's 27.4 in my apartment Celsius, according to my clock, my clock thermometer, which also does Celsius. I just had to wait for an appropriate time to be able to reach over and flip it over to Celsius. So yeah, it's getting pretty warm in my apartment here. Windows are all closed, because I was running the air conditioning earlier. It's really quite warm. Okay, now we're at 164 kilometers to go, so we should be okay. Oh, are you kidding me? I'm getting tired. Oh, this throws a monkey wrench in, because there's no time for a rest. How am I getting tired? Get 11 hours between sleeps. And I thought you automatically rested after every quick job. Or am I wrong about that? Oh, going a little too fast. Going a little too fast. Oh. 12th gear is the highest gear I have. I just tried to gear up, and nope, only got 12. I wanted to see if we could get the RPMs just a little lower, even out of the power band, just for the increased gas mileage, but I guess we don't really need that, do we? What? Are we back at that spot again? Yes, we are. Oh my god, is that closed too? It's closed both ways? How do I get there? Okay, we'll add another avoid. Avoid that. Okay, so we're going to have to... We're going to have to keep going north, and... Oh my god, I'm never going to get there! This is definitely an interesting ride. This is definitely an interesting ride. I need some water to deal with this. Oh my lord. I didn't realize it was closed in both directions. This is crazy.
Time to hit the road.
It's one of those things, I mean, I'm not sure why I slowed down so much. I guess maybe I hit the brake. This is absurd. Everything's shut down. I've never, ever seen something like this before, ever. This is amazing. Oh no, how long do I have until I have to rest? 1 hour and 4 minutes. And we're 4 hours away. Oh, this is a disaster. This is a disaster. I'm gonna have to rest. You know, I'm not supposed to need to. I don't understand why I have to. But...
Keep right, and then turn.
Oh, this is a disaster. I'm gonna have to rest, or I'm not gonna make any profit. I'm not going to make any profit if I don't rest, because I'm going to be getting fined constantly.
Keep right, and then turn right.
Oh, this is a right. Truly is a disaster. Oh no, it's going dark. Okay. Where can I rest? Oh my god, nowhere. There's nowhere to rest. Right here, I think that's a quarry. Other than that, there's nowhere to rest between... I almost want to cheat and turn fatigue off. I mean, that's not exactly cheating, but... I think that's the only way to save me from... I feel like an ass doing this. I feel like I'm cheating, but... I think I'm going to have to turn fatigue off. I really don't want to do that, but it's the only way to salvage this job. Okay, now we're fine. I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't like that I had to do that. Like, I really don't like that I had to do that. Okay, so... We still have enough gas. Oh, I feel like such a jerk turning that off. I feel like such a jerk. Like, I feel legitimately bad about doing that. I feel like I'm cheating hardcore right now. I might have to turn it back on and just face the consequences. Face the consequences of being this tired. Ooh, nice. Bullet train, I think. That's really cool. But in real life, it's getting really hot in here. It's just getting warmer and warmer, and I'm getting grumpy at this point, so... Yeah. What a disaster. Like, this is almost embarrassing that I've screwed this up this badly. I mean, it would be one thing if this was legitimately my third haul in this game ever, but it's not. I've been playing this game for years, well, on and off for years.
Keep right, and then exit right.
I'm actually kind of glad I'm recording this, because I want to... see exactly how long I've been driving at this point. I should have 11 hours. When did I start? It was like 4:30 in the morning, wasn't it? Oh, I'm going straight. Yeah, it was like 4:30 in the morning. So it's, oh my God, it's 3:14 in the afternoon. I've been driving for 12 hours? What? Oh, wait, the speed limit's really low here. This looks pretty at least. Yeah, it's really nice out in this part of Germany. Yeah, look at that. And look at that. Is that a guy with a radar gun or does he have a camera? Yeah, it is really. Yeah, let's try this real fast. Oh, look at this. Look at this. This actually. Oh, shoot. There's another game I play called. I play once in a while called The Hunter. And it has a reserve in central Germany in it. And this. I'm definitely getting strong vibes, so I'm going to say things have probably been modeled correctly. It almost feels like I'm, a professional video gamer making these kinds of videos as a living. I mean, I'm not. I don't have. I'm not partnered on YouTube, and I don't stream on Twitch. Even if I was, I'm not partnered on Twitch either. But it almost feels like I'm a professional gamer, and this is a really nice feel. Yeah, I definitely want to keep doing this. I mean, I've done it before, but I've never attempted to do it regularly. It was always just, oh shoot, I'm going too fast. It was always just whenever I felt like it. You know? Let's manually turn the retarder on. Manual retarder! Car blows by me. Hey buddy, how are you? Okay, 108 kilometers to go. I got 140 left in the tank. If I shift up, does it increase? Do I? No. Shouldn't it increase? I feel like it should. I'll tell you what, I cannot wait for this haul to be over, man. This has been a rough, rough haul. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, shoot. Gotta do something about that, gotta do something about that brake pedal. I have to. I know I say that every single episode, and I never look into it. I never attempt to do anything about it. I just say I have to, and, like, because I can't glide to a stop or just slow down a little bit. It's either touch it so lightly, there's almost no effect, or come to a complete stop. Like there's nothing in the middle. Oop, going too fast again.
Turn right.
Is the speed limit for cars. It's typically lower for trucks. feel like this is probably going to be my longest video ever. Or at least my longest trucking video ever, though I don't think anything else has been longer than this. Shoot, what's going on here? Ooh, that was a little bit. That was a little bit crazy. Okay, we're 61 kilometers to go and we got 94 in the tank. Cutting it so close. Oh, I do really like this DAF truck. I know I was thinking about a Volvo, but I have driven Volvos before. Ooh. I just saw, all I saw is brake lights come on. And I kind of freaked out a little bit. So we're looking 1 hour left. And I have, just over 7 hours left to deliver it, so I should be good. Okay, let's get her up to 80. Ooh, let me get over a little bit. I think I'm getting kind of far out. Ooh, what's happening here? I assume these are German provinces.
Keep right, and then exit right. Exit right.
Actually, I think I might have misread something earlier. It does look like there's enough time to account for a break, like a sleep, so...
To turn left.
Maybe I screwed something up here. Yeah, okay, so... I do feel bad about turning fatigue off, so just straight up, if I, next time this ever happens again, I am totally just taking it on the chin. I am not turning fatigue simulation off again. I do feel legitimately just so bad and like I'm cheating to do that.
Go straight up.
I mean, it's one thing to turn fatigue off if you're doing, like, a gimmicky thing like Squirrel's Four Trailer Haul. Which, if you've never seen that, you should watch it. It's just crazy absurd. A squirrel modded in a four trailer haul about right after the game released multi-trailer hauls. And he turned fatigue off, and it's just one of the craziest things ever. It's a fabulous video. I mean, it's one thing if, you know, he turned fatigue off for that, but for me to turn fatigue off because I'm just not paying enough attention to what's going on, that's kind of a level of cheating I'm not really comfortable with. Uh-oh, turbo pressure. What's that mean, turbo pressure? Oh, you know what that means. I'm in the wrong gear is what that means, I think. Oh, thank God, it's in view. Oh, thank God, it's in view. We're about to drop to 50. Okay, so I got a lot of... I got a lot of penalties on this. This is truly a... disaster. This is a big fail on my part. Big, huge fail. Well, we're just about done, guys. 2 kilometers to go, 6 minutes. At least we're going to get a discoverable here in a second. Can I see what it is in advance? Not really. Okay, just pull, remember you're with two trailers, pull a little to the left. Ah, looks like a recruitment agency.
Turn right.
Oh, turn right from here? No, not here. That's a recruitment agency.
Keep right, and then turn right. Turn right.
Okay, same deal as last time. Let's see if we can start in fourth. Or no, let's see if we can start in fifth, actually. Same deal as last time. Let's see. That's a little hard to start. We'll get them to the power band pretty quickly. Okay, keep it nice and wide. All right. I'm starting to get this dual trailer thing down, I think. I really only got stuck that one time, right at the very start.
And then turn right.
0 kilometers, 2 minutes. Thank you, Lord.
Turn right.
Come on. Okay, so I'm not even messing with it. I'm not going to try and back this thing in because I know I can't. Yes, it is all over, Sky. Ha 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 ha. That isn't even an option. I can't even take that. Okay. Let's get down a little bit. Hear my steering wheel there crunch for just a second because I turned it maybe a little too hard. Let's pull her over. Keep it wide. Just go real slow and swing into position. And there we go. Aw, did it. Okay. Shift into neutral. Parking brake on. Engine off. Whew. Well, guys, I gotta say, that was a disaster. I decided to take a quick picture there. I didn't feel like going into picture mode. I don't know if you heard that or not. But it's over. Oh, thank God. 14 hours? ...386 liters of gas, 781 kilometers on a drive that should have been 150 less, roughly. 14 hours. Wow. Well, we gained a level, so that's the good thing. Now, according to, if I recall correctly, I thought just in time would be the best for the next one. What I love about the early levels is that the early game is that the levels come fast and furious. Sometimes you can get a delivery every level. I mean, you can get a level every delivery. So I think after this, long distance will be the next. I think it should be long distance next. So we're walking out of here with 24 grand, which I have to admit that doesn't sound very good. I'll have to check the, video to see what we started with, but I think we started with like 22 grand. I think we earned almost nothing on this. Yeah, the... Dear Sir, Madam, we couldn't help but notice your steady earnings would like to assist you with developing your potential even further. Your credit limit has been raised to $500,000. Respectfully, Snarvly Bank Manager. Really? $500,000. I have no loans right now. I can borrow $400,000 for $5,700 a day. I don't know what I would ever need $400,000 for this early. I mean, I mean, you pretty much have to take a loan at some point, but this still seems too early. Like, I typically want at least 50 grand in the bank before I take my first loan, and that's usually for $100,000. Okay, guys, well, I think we're good here. I think we're all done for the day. So, I will see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.